without further ado, let's get travelling.
Something went wrong. I actually don't know where I am today. So let's go have a look around and see what we can find.
I haven't got a clue where I am. I can see a windmill, tulips. No idea. There's some deers in the distance. Ah, I see someone.
Excuse me, where am I? And what time period am I in?
I'm busy painting. This is 1885. You are in the Netherlands.
Are you Vincent?
No.
You're Vincent! You're like my favourite artist. Do you have any idea how good you are?
Yes, but nobody likes my paintings. My brother Theo, he tries to sell them, nobody likes them.
You have painted some of the best paintings in the world. They are now worth millions.
I haven't even sold one painting.
So, Vincent, tell us a bit about what colours you like and what paintings do you like yourself?
I like the Japanese prints. There is no blue without yellow and orange.
So, Vincent, before I leave you in peace, what advice would you give the people of the future back in England?
I dream of painting and then I paint my dream. If you truly love nature, you'll find beauty everywhere. I put my heart and soul into my work and I've lost my mind in the process.
Okay, so I've left Vincent Van Gogh in peace because I think I was annoying him. But now let's find out a bit more about his life and his paintings.
Who are you talking to?
Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes.
Vincent van Gogh was born in 1853 in the Netherlands. His paintings are now some of the most loved in the world, yet during his lifetime they were disliked and rejected. His paintings are now famous for their vivid colours and thick swirling brush marks. He painted with oil paints, and because of the amount of paint that he applied, they would have taken weeks to dry. Today we know about Vincent van Gogh because of his paintings. If we look into it, we can see his bedroom here. We can also see an old pair of shoes that told us that he would have been poor. We also know a lot about him through the letters that he wrote to his brother Theo.
I tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how.
His life was a tragic one, with no one really paying attention to the beauty of his artwork. It is estimated that Van Gogh produced over 2,000 artworks during his lifetime, 20 self-portraits and 800 paintings. This one here, the Red Vineyards near Arles, is the only one he actually managed to sell. Towards the end of his life, things got even more tragic. After an argument with Paul Gauguin, another artist and friend of his, he cut off part of his ear. He then later ended his life in 1890 after shooting himself in the chest. This song in the background by Don McLean is all about Vincent van Gogh's tragic life.
Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze, reflecting.
We will finish now with one time traveller to another. In the next scene, we will see a past Doctor Who episode where they took Vincent van Gogh to current times where he could finally see how much his paintings are loved today.
Where do you think Van Gogh rates in the history of art?
Well, big question, but to me, Van Gogh is the finest painter of them all. Certainly the most popular great painter of all time, the most beloved, his command of colour the most magnificent. He transformed the pain of his tormented life into ecstatic beauty. Pain is easy to portray, but to use your passion and pain to portray the ecstasy and joy and magnificence of our world, no one had ever done it before. Perhaps no one ever will again. To my mind, that strange, wild man who roamed the fields of Provence was not only the world's greatest artist, but also one of the greatest men who ever lived.
Vincent, sorry.
I'm sorry, is it too much?
No, they are tears of joy. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Sorry about the beard.
Listening still, perhaps they never